Good afternoon, guys. My name is Joo. I'm a product designer, and I'm currently working at Naver Now, a video and live stream platform in South Korea. I'm really excited to have this opportunity to share one of my best projects with all of the Figma fans today. Since last year, I have created a plugin for Figma and Joplin, which in the long term, I aim for it to become the AI spell checker for design systems. In this session, I will explain the key motivation that inspired me to begin this project. I will also discuss my experience in developing the Figma plugin, along with interesting feedbacks and reactions that I received as deploying this prototype last summer. The motivation of this project stems from my design system experience. Design system is a complete set of standards that are intended to manage design at scale using reusable UI components and UX patterns. Now, most of you here watch this live stream might be familiar with design systems, for example, Google Material Design. As you know, Google Material Design defined how to create Google-themed products through a common set of design standards and front-end components and more. So these days, design system is extremely common when it comes to creating new user interface for large-scale products and services to ensure their consistency and productivity. However, it still has major obstacles. One of which is the increasing complexity with the increasing number of UI components and patterns included in the same library. And another important thing is that it is super difficult to replace components one by one in the regular design files. Because of those kind of the complexity and problems, even if designers shape the same screen just like this, this one used the library exactly, but another one has regularity or detached instance just like this, and some of them even has just emoji or Unicode or whatever, something like that. So they look similar, but at the same time, they are completely different in the design system's point of view, right? In design system team, we work super hard to prevent those kind of human mistakes. For example, we update guidance website frequently. We also did design QA very often. And in my case, we even published cartoon manuals to make my designers easy to understand what is the design system and what kind of thing they should follow. But we all know that human resources were always limited. So we should think differently. And that is the point that I started thinking about how to solve this problem using machine learning. Because we all have been living with many automatic services using machine learning, such as face recognition and mask detection, for example. So if we can integrate the AI technology into our design work, that a computer runs the normal design element instead of the human, spell checks, and autonomously recommend the design grammar to human if we find something that does not conform to the guideline. This will not only be convenient for design system user, but it will also reduce tons of burden on people like me who should manage this system. After I point out this, I started to make it with TensorFlow and Figma, just like this. And Figma execute my program, take your time and click next. As you can see, my program draw many boxes and provide the checkpoint information. Let's dive into it. The sky blue boxes are UI objects found by TensorFlow.js. And the orange boxes are design system information provided by Figma. My plugin compared these two boxes, automatically find the mistakes and let designers know which part to revise. The name of this project is Figma-ML. And as you can see, I have been trying to create an AI spell check for design systems via Figma APIs and TensorFlow. It's fully open source. So if you are interested in this plugin, you can install it from GitHub or Figma community. It was a small project, but it wasn't easy for me to make it work. There were three major challenges that I faced and that I had to serve. A much larger UI data set and more optimized ML model. And finally, I had to find the best way to make my designers feel this AI power seamlessly on their design process. Since last year, I have been trying to solve those problems one by one. For data, I met a Singapore-based startup called Movin. They had over 50,000 high-quality mobile screenshots for product designers. It's really amazing data, so I contacted them and presented my project just like this and got over 10,000 high-quality UI screenshot data for free. Moreover, I received free rubbing support from Korean startup called SelectStar. We worked super hard together and annotated over 50,000 bounding boxes. It was a huge amount of the data, and I sincerely appreciate the contributions of those two companies to my project. We still have a really great relationship. After I prepared my data set, my next step was creating TensorFlow model. I downloaded some resources from Google TensorFlow Hub and custom trained so that they could detect the UI object and experimented with the performance of those models. After several experiments, I chose a model that's suitable for my project for UI detection. The result is just like this. Here is an example of a music app. And as you can see, these blue boxes are accurately highlighting UI objects right from the web browser in real time. If you want to find more technical detail, go to the TensorFlow YouTube channel and find the TensorFlow.js show and tell series that I involved recently. And the last challenge was how to utilize those AI detections on Figma and how to provide the useful information for designers based on my AI. So I decided to compare the detections to Figma's design system information. I started with drawing two different types of boxes on the iframe area on Figma plugin. In my assumption, each blue box should match up with a yellow one. If the design is not done perfectly, the boxes will not be aligned. So I decided to create a plugin and logic to point out this misalignment to the designer so that they know which parts they had to revise. So I added logic to select and compare boxes. For example, select by size. or overlapping areas. Finally, text similarity in rubbers. As a result, as you can see on the screen, I drew two different types of boxes on the iframe area on Figma plugin and pointed out the misalignment just right there, which means now the TensorFlow model that I trained with my custom UI dataset learns behind the web browser of Figma has begun to provide the useful information for designers. The best way to illustrate this to see in action together. The Figma-ML plugin. Choose the screen on Figma and execute my plugin. See what are there on the list and check the next button. And AI detected the UI and read the design to know what are the expected two problems. Just like this. Here. I also created the Javelin version for people who prefer to communicate through Javelin. Similarly, choose the model and then now the browser can recognize UI elements and compare the detection with design library and provide the checkpoint information through Javelin comment API. So in summary, I solved my challenges via a global partnership, transfer running and fine tuning, and Figma plugin. After distributing this prototype, I shared my story via my blog, Medium, and Twitter, and the reaction was so much fun. First of all, Anthony from Figma Design Advocate praised my project as a very interesting case. We had a lot of conversations and improved my project even further. Javelin introduced my project to their official newsletter and official Twitter channel as a super use case. I'm really appreciated and we still have a good relationship. Jason from Google TensorFlow team also praised this project as very interesting and amazing journey. Finally, I presented this project at the W21, which is one of the largest developer conferences in South Korea. It was an unforgettable memory to me. All of these responses were very grateful to me, and I'm currently trying to take this project to the next level. Let's dive in. Number one, the improved accuracy. It's super important, and I'm constantly striving to improve the detection and AI detection accuracy. All of my experiments are uploaded on GitHub. So if anyone wanted to see more detail, check out my project on GitHub and please contribute to your idea. And I'm also working on adding customizable feature for detecting users' design systems instead of detecting general UI objects. Finally, I'm trying to upgrade my plugin so that we can rent our styles and UX patterns beyond just discovering UIs. It was a huge project, so we need some more time to make it work, but we are trying to improve our project. Lesson one. I have gained a lot from this project. Among them, I wanted to let you know which ones were the most meaningful for me. when I look back on my design experience, one of the worst things happening at my workplace was the mastery of inefficiencies. Basically, if something were incredibly inefficient, I would eventually discover some of my own tricks, shortcuts, and master these inefficiencies. Then I would forget that the problem was incredibly inefficient and just continue to use my shortcuts and follow the norm. Design system has provided huge momentum to major shift our design process from tricking pixel to UI component-based communication. It's huge, but it is not perfect yet. There are a lot of inefficiencies out there. My case is also a kind of the small example. Previously, I thought it was not my job to solve these kind of problems, but through this project journey, I learned and finally realized that Figma is not just a UI tool, but a solution that helps solve the problems of our work design environment, our work environment. So the only thing we need to do is not put our problems behind us. There are a lot of plugin projects out there, and many plugin projects are still waiting for your contribution and your idea. So do not spend the rest of your life following the norm and take the chance to change the world and change our environment. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact me on Twitter or LinkedIn.